Domingo Zamudio, better known as Sam the Sham.
I am.
Remember that name, Domingo Zamudio?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, we were down at a club on Union Avenue called Smoochie Show Bar. Chip's Moment is playing guitar, Sam is singing, I'm the disc jockey and all that jazz, and with a little break in the action, and we get a little game going on the floor in the back room. And the police come in, ready to dice game and all. They go downtown. Everybody put their real name down. Chip's real name is Lincoln Wayne Moment. He put Chip's Lincoln Wayne Moment. The guy put Smoochie Jerry Lee Smith. That's his real name. Sam put Domingo Zamudio. And the reason I'm bringing it up, he had just signed a $1 million contract with MGM Records on Woolly Bully. And so nobody who knew Domingo Zamudio that got arrested in Memphis.
Now they know. Now when I'm trying to live right, I never get away, do I?
How you doing, Sam?
I'm doing fantastic.
Woolly Bully still kicking for you?
Yes.
You know, they say that Woolly Bully and Louie Louie were the two of the biggest party songs the kids love, you know.
Yeah. I saw it the other night in Happy Gilmore, I think it was.
You actually are a preacher.
Not a teacher, is more like it. Try to teach by example. You know, I studied, and you know, I'm not into body slamming folks and beating down folks that are already down. You know, I try to be an encourager. I studied under some great men, and I had the opportunity to, you know, work in the prison system for some of the guys in there. You know, I've been blessed. I've done some adventurous things. I've traveled with medical teams into third world countries and that kind of stuff.
When you go on something like that, Sam, do they recognize you as Sam the Sham, or you just say you're Domingo Zamudio?
I just say I'm Sam Zamudio, bilingual interpreter for medical teams, you know, because in the end of it all, you know, it's not the label. It's what you do, not who you are.
You got a book out on poetry.
Yeah.
Would you read us something from your poetry book?
Oh, man. This is not the sky is blue. I'll just read a couple of phrases.
Yeah.
This is kind of a romantic thing. It's okay. A breath of you. It says, I got a breath of you today. Me, I'm still kicking around. I may have drifted too far this time. So sad to crush a flower. So sad to walk away. Sadder yet, not to come back.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, a lot of people don't know, back in the day when Sam was on Atlantic Records, he won a Grammy for Liner Notes of the Year. If you ever get a chance, Hard and Heavy, pick up that album off the internet somewhere, but just read the liner notes. They are terrific on the back of that album. Sam, I know you got some product, got some records coming out or something.
I have this. This hasn't been released or got published, and my wife kind of gets on my case, says, you need to do something with all this work that you have. And what, you know, I say, well, don't worry about it. If I croak first, you can have a win out of business sale.
There's only one Sam the Sham. He's so much fun to talk to. I wish we had an hour with Sam. Woolly Bully, ladies and gentlemen, 1965. Check it out. The number one record in the world. Then he followed up with something unusually that doesn't happen in showbiz, unless you're a superstar. The follow-up, Little Red Riding Hood, was a million seller and went number one. Sam, you've always come down taking care of us on the show. We certainly appreciate that.
George, you've always been a gentleman, and I'm sure I'm not the only one, man. You helped us when we did get arrested, but it wasn't your fault.
Thank you, Sam. Sam, before we go, I'd be remiss if I didn't say, do the opening of Woolly Bully.
All right, looks like a Spanish class here, bilingual Tex-Mex. Uno, dos, one, two, tres, cuatro. My lawyer will call you in the morning.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's only one great guy, still lives in Memphis, Tennessee. Sam, Mr. Woolly Bully, Sam the Sham.